doth the Holy Spirit.
To make these your servants worthy ministers
through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, as in one body, we have many parts, and all the parts do not have the same function. So we, though many, are one body in Christ, and individually parts of one another. Since we have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us, let us exercise them with prophecy in proportion to the faith, with ministry in ministry, if one is a teacher in teaching, if one exhorts in exhortation, if one contributes in generosity, if one is over others with diligence, if one does acts of mercy with cheerfulness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So that whatever you ask the Father be made with you. This I command you, love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Let the one who is to be ordained a deacon come forward. Joel Philip.
Present.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain this man, our brother, to the responsibility of the diaconate.
Do you know him to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those concerned with his formation, I testify that he has been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and of our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose this our brother for the order of the diaconate.
Let the one who is to be ordained a priest come forward. Jacob Paul George.
Present.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain this man, our brother, to the responsibility of priesthood.
Do you know him to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those concerned with his formation, I testify that he has been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God, and of our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose this our brother, the order of the priesthood.
Thanks be to God.
Dear Archbishop, devoted Broglio, dear Bishop George, Pallipparambil, dear priests and deacons, together with all the fellow believers, dear George Philip, dear Jacob Paul George, we are gathered here in the name of Christ Jesus to celebrate the ordination to the diaconate of George Philip and to preach the ordination of Deacon Jacob George. Both have grown up in Dubai, where many people around the world do not expect Christians living there or to see religious and priestly vocations coming up. They are wrong. The fact that joy with Jacob are here proves the contrary. Also, their vocation and role may have known some doubts. I think particularly about Jacob, with whom I traveled thousands of miles across the Arabian desert during the years before he joined Mount St. Mary's. In the UAE, we enjoyed the excellent roads of which most of the countries in the world have only dreamed. The ways leading him to be ordained deacon last year and priest today were less comfortable. It took him more miles than originally planned. There were some diversions where we expected the way would go straight on. Beyond that, like on the roads of the UAE, Jacob as well as Joel experienced that both of you can look back with serenity and make your own the words of St. Paul in the letter to the Philippians. It is not that I have already taken hold of it or have already attained perfect maturity, but I continue my pursuit in hope that I may possess it, since I have indeed been taken possession of by Christ Jesus. Brothers, I, for my part, do not consider myself to have taken possession, just wanting, forgetting what lies behind, but straining forward to what lies ahead. I continue my pursuit toward the good, the Christ of God's upward calling in Christ Jesus. The reason for this confidence is given in the word of Jesus in today's gospel reading. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain. During today's ordination of Joel Philip as a deacon, there is a meaningful liturgical rite. I shall consign the book of the gospel to the new deacon with the words, "Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach." The handing over of the gospel book implies, therefore, personal consequences for the ordained. The word of God is externally transmitted, has become internally accepted and digested. It has to touch the innermost of the person and to change it. In the New Testament, the letter to the Hebrews is reminding us this basic fact. Indeed, the word of God is living and effective, sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating even between soul and spirit, joints and marrow, and able to discern the affections and thoughts of the heart. The first task of a deacon is to put himself in obedience under the word of God. Joel will be ordained deacon in view of his ordination as a priest. However, the dimension of the service is not a transitory one in the time of a future priest. It must remain an essential element throughout the whole ministerial life, because it is a substantial part of the mission of the Church. The Church would no more be the Church of Christ if the specific dimension of service would no more be inscribed in the daily life and mission. The Diaconate visible in a special way. Jacob today will become a priest in the Catholic Church. This is based on the call of Christ and not the human right that anybody could make a claim for it. It is the free choice of the Lord. And the rules of the Church help us to discern this carefully. Many people were instrumental in this presence, in this process. Your family, the community of grace, the Church experience in Arabia and in the United States, the staff at Mount St. Mary's Seminary, and many, many others. I am myself a witness that you have proved the authenticity of your priestly vocation, humbly accepting the humps which forced you to reduce the speed on the road towards today's ordination. We are called to be priests within and for the Church, but also within and for the world. It is important that we never forget that we are not called to priests but to our own pleasure and interest, but to the service of our sisters and brothers, who very often may not belong to the active inner circle of the Church. 3 months back, Pope Francis spoke to priests about the cultivation of a sense of being part of God's people. And he said, "We can only be missionary disciples all together. We can carry out our priestly ministry well only if we are fully part of the priestly people from which we ourselves have come. Realizing that we are part of a people never feeling separated from the journey of the holy faith of the people of God preserves us, sustains us in our efforts, accompanies us in our pastoral concerns, and keeps us safe from the risk of growing detached from reality and feeling all powerful. Let us be attentive to this, because it is also the root of every form of abuse." End of quote. In a few words, you are called to share the love of Jesus with your whole being, in what you are doing, in what you are living. As the Father loves me, so also love you. Remain in my love. Christ is taking you in his confidence and sends you out to spread his love wherever you learn to live. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. You are the chosen one. You do not make yourself a priest. You are a creation of the Lord, who looks at you with creative love. Dear Joel, dear Jacob, it is the Lord who generates you to be friends, not only of him and his Father in heaven, but also of those chosen race and holy priesthood who share in the mission of Christ. Your journey does not come to an end today. Rather, it takes a new leap of faith. You may have greater humps and deeper trials, but never forget that no matter how hard the journey is, the one who chose you will always accompany you to the end, where the crown of glory is prepared for all those who remain faithful throughout the journey. Dear son, before you proceed to the altar of the Diaconate, you must declare before the people your resolve to undertake this office. Do you resolve to be consecrated for the ministry of the Church through the laying on of my hands and the gifts of the Holy Spirit?
I do.
Do you resolve to discharge with humble charity the office of the Diaconate, so as to assist the priestly order to the benefit of Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to hold fast to the mystery of the faith with a clear conscience, as the Apostle says, and to proclaim this faith and worthy according to the gospel and the Church's tradition?
I do.
Do you resolve to keep the commitment of celibacy perpetually as a sign of the dedication of your life to Christ the Lord for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, kingdom of heaven in service to God and others?
I do.
Do you resolve to guard and increase the spirit of prayer proper through your way of life, and in keeping with the spirit and the circumstances of your life, to celebrate faithfully the liturgy of your hours with and for the people of God, and indeed for the whole world?
I do.
Do you resolve to perform your manner of life always to the example of Christ, whose body and blood will be handled at the altar?
I do, for the help of God.
Do you promise to respect and obedience to your order?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfill. Dear son, before you proceed to the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your resolve to undertake this office. Do you resolve to discharge unfailingly, with the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the office of the priesthood in the presbyterian rank as a trustworthy cover to the people of bishops in feeding the Lord's flock?
I do.
Do you resolve to carry out the ministry of the world virtue and wisely in the preaching of the gospel and the teaching of the Catholic faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate the mystery of Christ reverently and faithfully according to the tradition of the Church, especially in the sacrifice of the Eucharist in the sacrament of reconciliation, for the grace of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to implore with us the mercy of God for the people entrusted to you with zeal for the commandment to pray without ceasing.
I do.
Do you resolve to be united more closely each day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, to begin to consecrate yourself to God for the salvation of all?
I do, with the help of God.
Do you promise respect and obedience to your ordinary?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Let us pray, dearly beloved, that God, the Almighty Father, will, in his mercy, pour out the grace of his blessing on these his servants, whom he is pleased to receive into the sacred order of the Diaconate and the priesthood.
Pray for us.
believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Let us pray, dearly beloved, to God the Father of God, that He pour forth heavenly gifts. Draw near, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, Author of human dignity and Discorder of all grace, through whom all things progress, through whom everything is made firm, who, by the power of the Holy Spirit, in all of the form that brings the people, establish among them ministers of Christ, your Son, in their years forth. Already in the earlier covenant, there arose offices instituted by mystical rites, so that when you have set Moses and Aaron over your people, to govern and sanctify them, you chose men next in order to the dignity, to join them and assist them in their work. Thus, in the desert, you instilled the spirit of Moses in the minds of 70 wise men. With them as helpers, he more easily governed the ministry. So, through all the sons of Aaron, you bought an abundant share of their father's fullness, that the number of things prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifice of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus the Apostle and High Priest of our progression. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself unblemished to you and made his apostles, who were consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. To them you added companions to proclaim and carry out the word of salvation to all the world. Now we pray, O Lord, provide also for our witness this helper whom we need for the exercise of the apostolic ministry. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to this your servant the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within him the spirit of holiness. May he hold the office second in all, receive from you, O God, and by the example of his manner of life, may he inspire right conduct. May he be a trustworthy converter in our order, so that by his preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts, and reach even to the end, of the earth. Together with us, may he be a faithful steward of your mystery, so that your people may be renewed. Through the cleansing waters of rivers and refreshed from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled to the sick raised up. May he be joined to us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to him and for the whole world. Thus may he, the full number of the nation gathered together in Christ, become your one people, drawn to perfection and unity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God of ever and ever.
Amen.
May the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
sacrifice and yours may be accepted, Lord.
Granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Lord, in the wicked and be in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Lord, into your servants, for we have many reclamation heavenly food and drink, that for the sake of your glory and the salvation of believers, they may be found faithful as ministers of the gospel, of the sacraments, and of charity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To Archbishop Broglio, who generously offered me a place to live and work after I finished my seminary studies a year ago. Moreover, he ordained me to the Diaconate last December, which I consider one of the greatest honors I've ever received. To all of you, thank you for your love, for your continued support, and your prayers. Special thanks to Monsignor Vicar, the rector at the Mount, for all this support. He was instrumental in seeing that our ordinations would be possible today. To all the others who came here from the Mount, the faculty, their families, and the staff and all the seminarians, especially the deacons, I'd like to say that my seminary class of 2023 and ordination class of 2024. Thank you. We'd like to especially thank the MC, John Rusa, the sacristans, servers, and the beautiful scola for sharing their outstanding talent with us this liturgy. We especially appreciate Mr. Nicholas Will for organizing the music so beautifully. Thank you to the Seton Shrine, for Rob, Becca, Hannah, and Tony for their unfailing and constant help in ensuring all the arrangements for the celebration today went as smoothly as possible. To the beautiful daughters of charity, for their presence and for allowing us to use their beautiful Basilica. I've always held St. Elizabeth Ann Seton in high regard, and I'm honored to have our ordinations here. We'd like to thank our community, the community of grace. Although I felt called to the priesthood from a very young age, and it was through the charism of the community that I was to become a priest, and I consider this perhaps the greatest blessing.
although I never met them while they were alive, they never ceased to inspire me with their love for the Word of God and their passion for bringing the good news. I especially thank our moderator, Brother Willis, who always prefers being called Brother Willis, not Father Willis, who has been a spiritual father to me for over 20 years. If you know me, but you haven't heard of Brother Willis, then you probably don't know me. He's also played a tremendous role in organizing several elements to make today possible. And I also thank Brother Joan, Brother John, and Brother Eddie, who have accompanied me as big spiritual brothers for most of my life. Hopefully my voice has been unstabilized by children. And they've flown all the way from Dubai and Italy today to be here for this ordination. I'm indebted to the three of you, Brother Willie, Brother John, and Brother Eddie, in more ways than I can ever. I'd like to especially mention Nathan and Karen Wright, who have played a huge role in organizing many details for this event and the reception. But it would have been a disaster without them. So thank you, Nathan and Karen. Thank you to all our friends and other community grace members who have flown in from far and wide, from Australia, from Singapore, from India, from the UAE, from Ireland. You can guess it's one from Ireland. We would like to thank all the priests who have come, too many to list individually. I'd like to make special mention of some priests who have greatly influenced my formation but have since passed away. Father Lee Rose, who was my spiritual director at the moment until 2021. But Father Gandalf Neal, a Swiss Capuchin missionary I worked with in Abu Dhabi. For Monsignor Michael Egan, a diocesan missionary in Vicar. He served as an undercover priest in Saudi Arabia for over 20 years. For Father Daniel Zephyrini, a Capuchin missionary, and the first pastor I remember. And for Father D.K. Matthews, a Malaysian missionary in the Northeast, who played a great role in my own formation, especially vocal protection. I have no doubt that their intercession made today possible. Finally, I would like to thank those who have accompanied us on our journey, but could not be here due to the challenges involved in travel, the sight of the world, family and friends, community members, including Joel's parents, David's brother and Nessie's sister, and his big brother, Joe. In conclusion, I certainly feel like my journey feels good and Joel's journey is the evidence of progress. Been unique and more than one unexpected turn along the way, but I feel overwhelmed with the love and support I've experienced from all of you throughout the journey. You all have probably played a bigger role than you think in my formation and in Joel's formation. There's one thing that has been made clear, is that God loves me, that God loves us. And as St. Paul says, you can truly turn everything for the good in Romans 8:28. Experiencing that and realizing that he has the same love for each one of us makes me eager to love and serve him in every person I come in contact with. I joyfully place my trust in his grace and mercy to faithfully carry me to the end. And to all of you present here, finally, for all those who have joined online, know that we love you and are always there for you as much as we can, as your friend, as your brother, as your deacon, and as your priest. And now, like any good priest, I have to make some logistical announcements. So immediately following the Mass, we'll be hosting a reception, as many of you know, at Patriot Hall at Mount St. Mary's University. All the guests attending the reception are requested to proceed to the mount
whether it was science directing you to a parking lot near Patriot Hall. If you need any assistance with transportation, please reach out to any of the seminarians. They'll be wearing flags so you can see them find any of the people on the side. So they'll be happy to assist you. We reserved a space in the Welcome Center, at the, which is a building near the Patriot Hall, where I'll be giving the first blessings. Joel and I look forward to greeting you there. At the end of the Mass, after all the bishops, the priests, deacons, servers have processed out, please remain in your seats, because we all have to get back here to the sanctuary for some official pictures. And once we're back, then you can. Thank you for your patience.
Amen. Jacob and Joel want us in the picture, I think. Really? They said priest. They said service.
The one year picture.
It was never meant to be the main thing.
Okay.